So, students, now we will look at simple interest. Okay. So, what is interest? Interest is the money paid for the use of borrowed money or the return on invested capital. Capital means any investment which you make on an asset. That is known as capital. The economic cost of construction, installation, ownership, or operation can be estimated correctly only by including a factor for the economic cost of money. So, there is an economic cost of money, and especially if you borrow the money, then you have to pay interest. So, what is simple interest? We will see two types of interest. One is simple interest, another is compound interest. The simple interest is the interest that is computed only on the original sum and not on the accrued interest. Okay. Suppose I take, again we will come to the motorcycle case. We have borrowed a sum of 50,000 rupees. Okay. And we take it at a simple interest of 10%. So, after 1 year, how much I pay? 50,000 rupees plus 10% of that is 5,000. So I pay 55,000 rupees. This is simple interest. So I am paying the interest on the original sum and not on the interest, accrued interest. Suppose now you take the case that I borrow 50,000 rupees for buying a bike, and that is not on simple interest, that is on compound interest, and their compounding is done on a monthly basis. There are some lenders, I think you might have seen, who lend short-term money, lending for months together. That is on a compound interest they can charge. So what happens? So if you say they charge you around on a compound interest rate. On a monthly basis, compounded monthly. So what happens? So this 50,000 rupees, it will not become, the interest will not become 5,000 at the end of 1 year, because you are calculating only simple interest, where you are not, the accrued interest is not taken into consideration. Whereas if you take it as a compound interest, then this 50,000 rupees every month it gets interest. So that interest will also be used for calculating the further interest. That is known as compound interest. If you were to take a loan, a present sum of money P, say at 50,000 rupees, to some point at a simple annual interest rate I may be 10%. So this 10% will become 0.1. Sorry, it will become 10%. Okay, 10 by 100 is 0.1 only. And then amount of interest you would be received, the loan would be, total interest will be, P is the principal amount and I is the interest amount, and N is the number of period. What is it? Like years, months. At the end of the years, the amount of money due to you, F will be the, F means the final amount, would be the equal amount of loan, that is the P, plus the total interest earned. So final amount F will be the principal amount. Principal amount is the amount you have taken as loan, 50,000 rupees. So the interest is 5,000 rupees. So the F will become 55,000 rupees. That is the amount of money due at the end of the loan period after 1 year. So F is equal to P in bracket 1 plus I into N. So here you can see F is equal to P plus P I N. So here P is constant, is there in both the terms. So I'll take out F outside. F is equal to P in bracket 1 plus I into N, where P is the present sum of the money which I am borrowing, say 50,000 rupees. F is the future sum of money what I have to pay after 1 year. Say I have borrowed for 1 year. N is the number of interest periods. That is, now I have taken वन ईयर इंटरेस्ट रेट आई हैव कंसिडर्ड इट एज 10%. सो दिस बिकम्स एफ इज इक्वल टू पी इन ब्रैकेट 1 + IN. दिस इज द वे यू कैलकुलेट द सिंपल इंटरेस्ट. इवन यू टेक दिस केस of 50,000 rupees borrowed today and I have to pay after 1 year and the interest rate is 10%. So what happens? F is equal to P is 50,000 rupees. P is 50,000 rupees in bracket 1 plus I is interest rate. That is 10%, 0.1 into what is the this number of years? 1. So it is 1 plus 0.1. It is 1.1. So 50,000 into 1, that is 50,000 plus 50,000 into 0.1, that is 5,000. So F becomes 50,000 plus 5,000, that is 55,000. So you got it. So the final amount which I pay after 1 year will be F, and the present amount what I have borrowed is 50,000, that is P. Okay. Interest rate was 10%, which I consider as 10/100, that is 0.1, and the period what I was taken for 1 year, that is I written 1. So F is equal to P in bracket 1 plus I into N. Please remember I should be in decimals. Okay, this was about simple interest.